Pick it all up and start again. You've got a second chance, you could go home, escape it all, it's just irrelevant. It's just medicine. It's just medicine. You could still be what you want to, what you said you were when I met you. You've got a warm heart, you've got a beautiful brain, but it's disintegrating from all the medicine. From all the medicine. From all the medicine, medicine. You could still be what you want to be, what you said you were when you met me. You could still be what you want to, what you said you were when I met you, when you met me, when I met you.
The wrong camera comes on.
Until you have a real home. You do it to yourself. You do. That's why I love you. No, 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 don't get my sympathy. How you're not the 54. Change like 3 times. Stuck a meal into them. When did I get to you? Teach you how to get to purest. Hell, you do it to yourself. You do.
Why is he messing up? Did this? Sassy Cat. MJ Ball the Hardest. That's awesome. I'll talk about that in a moment. Gonna bore you guys to tears. This is actually topic driven. Remember, folks, every song has an idea about what I'm talking about, or the different topics I like to be talking about. Pay attention. You've got to be pretty smart.
Throw your keys in the bowl, kiss your heart's blood at night. And forget about your house of cards, I'll do mine. Forget about your house of cards. For the table, guess where?
That folks, sorry.
Twilight fades through blistered Avalon. The sky's cruel torch on aching Autobahn. Into the uncertain we scream into the last divide. You make me weak. You make me strong. Take eyes, leave passing vapor trails with blushing brilliance. Because it's time to arrive. Summer star races all of me. Highway war sings silent poetry. and I couldn't bring you the light and take you home into the night. Lately I just can't seem to believe. Just got a friend to change the scenery.
How's the sound, guys?
It's kept the world hearts of losing faith. And now it's just a matter of grace.
Aloha and welcome, folks. My name is RPJ. Sorry, ain't wrong. Aloha and welcome, folks. My name is Johnathan Steele, and this is the Johnathan Steele Show. How are you? How you doing? What is up? What's going on with you? Me, I am Swell City. Tonight's topic is reality stars of the black or African-American persuasion, or African-Blacks, African-Americans, whatever they call you, wherever they call us, and their impact on society, or vice versa. Or are there visions of a white America, white gay America, white gay black, white gay America against or looking at America? But you guys remember, it's only 12 to 13 or the 14% of America is black. It's always been this, it's actually been worse, but this is probably the best we're going to get. And for the last 40 years, 12, 13 to 14% has been black America. Media has been mostly white, 80s, 90s, odds, and 2014s, 13s, 16s, whatever, has been white, gay America, the media, that is. And this is how they view black America. Poverty in black America, it's been the same. Hasn't gotten much better, gotten much worse. You have more opportunities if you are 6'9". You can dribble a basketball. You can run the 40 at 4.2. You can box. Those are your great throughs. All you can sing, and most, of course, black people can sing. Even I stereotype black America. Yeah, you can sing. You can dance. Of course, when you dance, you're homosexual, and that's, you know, whatever that is, but you have to be an entertainer. Entertain me. Put the ball in the hoop. Score the touchdown. Blacks don't play baseball anymore. I play baseball. I was pretty good. I could throw 96 miles per hour at my best. That's what Coney Island miles per hour speed gun told me. 96 is my best. Even now, I can still throw a good baseball about 88, 89 miles per hour at my best. I can sustain that because of how I work out, but That's a whole nother story for another day. And this is not my ego telling me. I just did this like a couple years ago before when I came back here to America. Anyway, I love talking about myself because I'm great. I do want to talk about reality stars of the Black or African American persuasion, MTV, VH1, and all this other nonsense. Why does it seem that Black reality stars from old, from Flava Flav or Flava of Love, to now Love and Hip Hop, now New York, Atlanta, wherever the fuck it is, Los Angeles, I have no idea where these places are. It seems that Black America seems to accept this as the standard. And it's mostly poverty-stricken to low middle class, that this is the standard of how Black Americans should live. Like, hey, if I see these Black women on here with the weaves and wigs and long fingernails and buttocks juice, buttocks and all that nonsense, and I mean, what happened to regular buttocks? Regular buttocks? Oh, I love regular buttocks. It sounds funny when I say it like that, but what happened to that? The standard of Black America economically and politically and parentally impaired seem to identify with the pseudo intellect, the stupid culture, the consumer culture that America builds behind. They identify with these stupid, silly, fucked up shows where you have a woman like, what's her name? Snoop from Love and Hip Hop New York. Richie Rich or Richie Paul or whatever these fucking guys' names are. Who, and this other guy who fucking has a wife that's so pretty, she's beautiful. She's young and stupid. But he has his older wife, his real wife, I mean his wife that he left, this beautiful woman. And she is not bad looking. I mean, she spent 13 years or 17 years, whatever the fuck it was. So I saw this on a Love and Hip Hop reunion fucking New York shit show. This guy, and you know what's gonna happen? This guy is gonna get more poutine. He's gonna get more women than ever before because he's on his show, because they look at him as a celebrity. I look at him as shit. I look at women who follow him as shit. I look at people who want to be with Richie Paul. I don't even know these guys' names. As shit. You follow him, he's a piece of shit, and you want to be with him because what? He's not good looking. It's like the same. It's like I said the same thing about Beyonce. No offense. For Beyonce lovers. The Beyonce lovers, look at Beyonce was a 20-year-old, 22-year-old, 25-year-old with a 38, 37, 39, 40-year-old frog face. Frog face Jay-Z. Who I didn't think that he is talented. He's not talented as Eminem or Biggie Smalls, or definitely not Tupac. He's not even in the big three. Frog face Jay-Z got a Beyonce. Frog face Jay-Z got a Beyonce. I'll put my camera on in a minute. Let me just say my opening monologue real quick. I say a lot of this has to do a lot of this self-hatred or self-indulgence or self-bullshit, I say this starts with the 80s generation, where you had liberals, women's liberation, telling black women, you're independent. You can do better. You don't have to settle for this. Break up your marriages, your boyfriends. Don't get married first. Have a baby. Get in the system. Then pick your perfect man. That's what I told them. Then you had the crack epidemic, which affected both men and women. It destroyed black families left and right. It was just funny how I lived in New York, and upstate New York, Long Island, New York, Queens didn't get affected by it, but Brooklyn got destroyed by it. I live in a middle class neighborhood as a kid, and it was great. I live a middle class lifestyle. Seriously, I don't make this up. I'm not rich now, you know, I'm poor as hell. But I live in a middle class neighborhood, and it turned into the crack epidemic, destroyed the whole community. And then I moved into a worse neighborhood into my teens. Good thing I had sports to hold me down. Organized sports where I played football, basketball, baseball, and then later on softball, baseball, football, and then I played, you know, semi-pro football for a long time. And I met all types of different women and families and societies, from Japanese to Chinese to Italian. I met my first wife was Italian. My kid's mother was Irish, Puerto Rican. So I had all the opportunities to see different kind of cultures. And from that point on, I decided that, you know what, if I ever got a chance to leave and travel the world, I would travel the world. And that's what I've been doing my entire life from 30 on. Like 27 on, and then I joined the army in 30 something. Anyway, I'm getting off track. I say this has been done by design. The 80s generation has destroyed, from the liberals, women's liberation, who destroyed black women's minds, cannibalized their minds, cannibalized the whole black community, cannibalized black children, black women, liberals, white women's liberation, because white liberation, all they want to do is to compete with their white husbands who are on top of the food chain already. The standard of black America, economically impaired, politically impaired, apparently impaired, seems to identify with these pseudo-intellectuals or these pseudo-idiots or these TV idiots, culture of black Americans, who come across as me-only thinkers, self-indulgent, without conscience, and instant gratification. This is where we're at, folks. I can come on camera now. Well, you're not. Here I come. You can't hide. Give me a moment. Let me plug into my good microphone. All right, shut up. All right, 1 second, folks. Give me one moment. One moment. One moment. One moment. If you can hear me already. Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? Hello? Hello? All right, let me see.
Ah, there she is. And save. And Rockstar. Hello, hi, and welcome, folks. My name is RP. Hello, hi, and welcome, folks. My name is Johnathan Steele. This is the Johnathan Steele Show. How are you? How you doing? What's up? What is going on with you? Me, I am swell. So swell, I'm in swell heaven. Or swell hell. How are you? How you doing? What's up? What's going on with you? Me, I'm so swell. I say all those things before it falls because I am so disappointed. I have no idea where all these things come from. I don't understand how people so easily just don't question things that are happening amongst them. Why be a consumer? If you're poor, how can you be a consumer? And being a consumer is the best thing that you can be. To be down with the Joneses, as it were. Hey, listen, I want spinning rims too. I want my Jeep. I want the lights underneath my Jeeps to light up. Meanwhile, you're going to get pulled over by the police every time. I never did that because I'm not a consumer. I have never been a consumer because I learned to light like at 17, 18, 19 years old because that stuff doesn't matter. Because all I really wanted in life was to be loved. You know, I have a tragic upbringing of abuse and all that nonsense. So all I want to do, all I want is passion. But, you know, sometimes I'm so passionate sometimes where I take chances on situations where I shouldn't take chances on because I'm desperate for passion. I just want to be loved. I just want to give love. So I took a chance. I take chances. Then my ego gets in the way. Oh, wait a minute. All these women want to talk to me. Oh, they want to see me. Oh, okay. So you know what? I'm going to travel the world. Here's a woman over here. Here's a woman in Venezuela. Here's a woman in Cyprus. Here's a woman in, you know, Germany. They all want RBJ, and if I have the money, and so, you know, most of the time I've had the money, most all the time I've had the money. So I travel out there, I take a chance, and I do want to travel. I love traveling. I love traveling the world. There's, you know, difference for me than like little white girls, no offense to little white girls, they won't get, if you go to Mexico, if I go to Mexico, no one's going to kidnap me, which is not in a way not funny, but no one's going to kidnap a little black boy, a little 25-year-old black kid, a little 29-year-old black kid, a little 31-year-old black boy, black man. All right, anyway, let's go to my channel here. I'm reopening the Johnathan Steele Show. I want to say thank you to Sassy Cat. Thank you to MJ Ball the Hardest for stopping by and checking me out. And Merry Christmas. Give me your money. I beat you up into all your toys. Look at this. All the little white songs I know, huh? Sounds good? Okay, good. I'm going to take a sound check real quick. I'm going to hear what it sounds like. Me, 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 me. Hey, 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 hey. Ay, 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 ay. Oh, 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 oh. You. Hello? Hey, 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 hey. Ay, 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 oh. I don't hear anything. I don't hear anything. You guys hear me good? All right. Sounds good. You said Sassy Cat. So I'm going to go with you, Sassy. Thank you, Sassy, for stopping by and checking me out. This is one of the first shows of the Johnathan Steele Show. I did a show like two weeks ago. And for those who don't know, I was in an accident and shrapnel happened to, I said lacerated, but more than pinpricked my liver. So I was hurt for a few days, and I'm still very sore, and I had a little surgery, and I didn't say this on my RPJ show, but because this is a more serious show. So here I am now that now I'm fully, well, I'm not fully healed. I'm actually in a lot of pain. They actually put me on morphine, which is fuck your head up. It's retarded. However, it was necessary, and I spent 4 days in the hospital. I thought I'd just go in there for, like, you know, give me a couple of, you know, antibiotics, and I spent 4 days in the hospital. I thought I'd go in the hospital for like 4 hours, give me some antibiotics, and it'll be done. I spent 4 days in the hospital and test and a little minor surgery, and I'm in pain right now, but I decided that I'm going to do a few shows before Christmas. I'm going to take the Christmas to New Year's off, and hopefully I'll be, shrapnel. I was in a little bit of a car accident, and plexiglass pierced through my body, and it punctured a piece of my liver. Immediately they took me in, and I thought, oh, I go to hospital and they're gonna give me some antibiotics. It's the silliest thing. Or maybe I'm retarded, and I am retarded, because I've never been hurt so bad, and I've been through Army and Brooklyn and 90s Brooklyn. Pierced my belly, and I just thought, okay, just give me some antibiotics and I can go home. They immediately sent me in, took me upstairs, x-rayed me, MRI me, and surgery me immediately. And I was like, whoa, for what? It's just a little puncture. I mean, shit, I got punched in the stomach harder than that. I mean, not that it didn't really hurt me. I wasn't really hurt. I was in a car accident. Somebody ran into me. Maybe I shouldn't tell you. I'm not going to talk too much, just in case things might happen later on. But yeah, I was in an accident. Not my fault. Somebody ran to me, and they, you know, windshield puncture into me. So anyway, moving on. I do want to talk about, and if my guest might come on. Well, you know what? I had no eating diet. The last day until I did a poop, they wouldn't release me. So I forced to have a poop so I can get out of there. I've been there for too long. This is ridiculous. 4 days for something I thought it might take a day. Like, hey, give me some antibiotics. Like, you know, I got punctured. You don't stitch my stomach up, because it's not that much. Nothing's leaking through that much. Anyway, I don't want to talk about me, per se. I mean, I love talking about me, but I want to move on. Back to the topic. Black reality stars. It seems like they are the leaders of communities, or they are the byproduct of what communities are now. Now, I talked about this like maybe on the RPJ show, and you guys probably go back and forth. This is the same show, really. But I'm going to transition these shows off, as because I've Now I'm back to normal. I got my nighttime job, my overnight job. And that's fine because it kind of fits with when I do my shows at 8 to 12, then 12, I go to 12 or 1 o'clock, I go to work, 1 to 6, I get up, 6 o'clock, I get up in the morning, my clients. Well, I have to get my clients back up again. And you know how it's wintertime, you lose clients because no one wants to get up when it's cold. However, this is Florida, so it's never cold. It's never that cold. So, which I have a great chance to make a great living here, which I was doing before I left here, and I should never have left to go to, you know, to Australia in the first place. I was doing actually pretty decent. When I went to Australia, I went to hell, but that's a whole different story. That's for the RPJ show. This is the Johnathan Steele Show. I want to talk about topics. I just noticed that, I don't know, it seems like the media, and I don't know if my lady is here. I have a new girlfriend. She is beautiful. She's Asian and Irish. You know, she's Asian for sure. You can see that in her looks, but she definitely has Irish. You know, her father's Irish. She's not here tonight. I want her to be here because I want to do back and forth shows, and maybe I might say that for the new year because you know she has to spend time with her family. I spend time with my family here and there, New York, and right now I don't have enough money to go to New York back and forth like I you know like normally because I was sick for a week, so I was sick for 3 weeks actually, so. Anyway, that's a whole different story. I was thinking that maybe the culture of reality TV, black reality TV, has a offsetting. They parlay into normal America, normal black America. I'm gonna separate it because it's black America and white America wants to be like black America. And I know white people don't say, hey, we don't wanna be like black America, but there is a thing here where black America follows suit of their black America reality stars. Now, I don't see a lot of black Americans wanting to be like Denzel Washington. I want to be like Denzel Washington. I think that I'm better looking than Denzel Washington right now. He's about 12 years older than I am. 12, 13 years older than I am. I'm in better shape. I've always been in better shape, except when he did the hurricane. Well, I was always in better shape than Denzel Washington. Right. Vin Diesel, who is biracial. I can't believe that you guys. Anyway, my ego gets in the way of me. Again, this is a topic-driven show. And I'm just concerned is that is the media making black Americans fools, or is black Americans make the media turn black Americans into fools? If you copy what I'm saying, because you see shows like Empire and reality shows like Love and Hip Hop and the Prancer Dancers, whatever that show was, VH1, Love and Hip Hop, and I don't know these shows because I don't watch them. You know, you had old shows like Flava of Love. Flavor Flav. You know, no offense to Flavor. He's one of the ugliest black people persons I've ever seen ever. Ugliest human beings, and he's retarded. Then you got this Cardi B, who is retarded, but she's kind of Hispanic. She's retarded, you know what I'm saying? And then you got this Snoop, who is the ugliest lesbian man, lesbian woman I've ever seen. These are the standards. And then you guys go, and then, you know what? I actually got to give Snoop a little credit. Snoop managed to get a beautiful woman who to leave her child behind four states over because Snoop is a celebrity actress. Oh, she's female, but everything about her is male. She walks like she has a penis, or she walks like she has a strap on. This is the best that we can do, and this is the best we can show on TV, and this is the best. And by the way, why is this being shown? Why is this being fucking shown out? The worst of Black America, to me, is what I think. You got guys, a guy who looks older than me. He's probably younger than me. I don't know. Loving Hip Hop New York, who has a wife of 13 years, and then he leaves his wife for 13 years for a young woman, and which, you know, I can attest to. I've done that thing, but I wasn't married. But she was bipolar and retarded and violent. But the next woman will probably be not as young and retarded and bipolar, but because I'm active, you know, I'm an active guy. I'm physically fit and active, whatever. He can go on air knowing that he goes on air knowing that he looks like he's 52 years old, maybe he's 48, 45 years old. 45 to 52 years old, a 13-year relationship with kids and everything to a 29 to 33, 34-year-old woman. I don't know the show, so I don't know these people's ages. So she's beautiful. It's beyond. She's a little silly, stupid, and simple. She believes, and I actually believe that she actually loves him and doesn't believe it's about money. this is such a silly world of silly people. You know, it's a good thing. Despite my abuse, I'm being abused. At least I knew what manhood was. No tears, no crying. You know, you take your beatings, you get off the field. Then you got sports. You take your beatings. You have to feel when you win is greatness. You win again is greatness. Girls come, older women come, you get stalked a little bit. It's greatness because someone's feeling avoided me where, you know, hey, I want love too. And then it goes a little crazy. You know, they picking you up every day. It's a little nutty. You don't really understand it because, you know, you're 14 to 16 years old. You don't understand that, hey, you find some greatness and you're having somebody loving you and, you know, older women, beautiful, beautiful older women giving you everything, stalking you. Yeah, all right, fine. You know, it's weird, but, you know, in a way, can it help me? You know, being stalked, can it help me? You know, at least someone cares about me. Someone loves me. Someone loves me a lot. Someone loves me too much. My first marriage was about she didn't stalk me, but she loved me too much. Like, you know, consuming me. Every second I spend with her. I work with you. I spend time with you. I marry you. We go out clubbing. We threesomes with you. I mean, whatever, you know, it's too much. I just don't want to do this anymore. I don't want to be consumed. All right, I got my fill of being loved. Anyway, I'm talking about me too much. This is not the RPJ show. This is Johnathan Steele Show. This is more about topics. So I say, folks, listen. I think the media, white America media, gay American media is making fun, having fun at black people's expenses, because black people, like me as a kid, wanting some attention, wanting to be loved and liked, or first liked and loved, will spread themselves thin and expose themselves to the media, and the media exposed them. A white America exposes them. Not of all white, I mean, all white gay America wanting, it's actually some of black wanting to be exposed, wanting to be seen and shown as they are, and hoping beyond hope that maybe this helps me out of this situation. Maybe I can make something out of this situation. It really is. It's really that simple. I didn't think that hard. It's not that hard to think that hard. It's not that hard to think that hard. It's really not that hard to think that this is not the situation. Remember, the country is 70%+ white America, and it's always been that way. It might have been more like 80% before, you know, might have been more than that. But mostly it's been 70%+ America. Let's say over the last 40 years, it's been 12, 13, 14, 12, 13. It's been that percentage of black America in this country. And they want to be seen, they want to be heard, they want to have a voice. And then liberals said, let's take advantage of this. Welfare. Get rid of your husbands out of your households. Get rid of that. We don't need you to have a husband. Get rid of him, and you can have welfare. You don't have to work for you never have to work. And then they start pulling it back. You don't have to work for like 10 years. You don't have to work for like 5 years, 3 years. And then they start having babies that they don't want by men. They lust for the moment, never last situation. They never last a year. White America, the white politicians that set black Americans up, and poor, I do poor people another time. They have set up black Americans for absolute failures because they have bought into this whole democratic situation. But I don't believe in Donald Trump. You know, fuck Tommy Sotomayor and Donald Trump. You know, that I'm not anti-woman. Absolutely not. Some people say I'm anti-black women because I don't think that black women, I don't date women who don't like themselves. I don't date women that, unless they are actresses. I dated one black actress like when I was like 19 years old. She was a black actress. She worked at a bank as well. I dated one black actress one time, and she was gorgeous. And because I could have any woman in the world at that time, you know, on my mind. Why am I not moving here? I'm sorry. I don't see myself moving here. Am I been talking to myself the whole time? How do you like me now? Oh, all right. Sorry. All right. Anyway, it's funny. I dated one black girl, young lady, because I was young too. She was an actress, one black actress. She worked at a bank, and she was a black actress. And that's when I first started acting, way back when. I forget my point. But sorry, I'm looking at my fucking stuff here. I think the RPG shows, Bad Girls Club, right? Bad Girls, oh my God, the Bad Girls Club, no. It's amazing what people will do to get attention. You know, if I sit here and tell you all my truths, I'm gonna break my character here. I'm gonna just talk to you from off the top of my head, which is not this show really. I actually want to do more topic based shows, but I'm gonna break a little topic. I'm gonna break this little character here. I can be whatever I want to be. I can do, even at 40 plus years old, I still can do whatever I want to do. I could be selfish as hell, and I wouldn't have a problem with that. I can date any woman in the world, and I wouldn't care what her race, color, creed, whatever. Yeah, all right. Yeah, I can. I wouldn't care. I mean, as long as she's a woman, of course. I don't care. If you love me, I love you. And you want to, you give to me, I give to you. Is that a? I give to you easily. I want to give. I don't want to be hurt anymore. I don't want to be lied to. I don't want to be deceived to. I don't care. If you have, the only things is that certain things is beyond my control. Like, as an adult to a kid, I can handle bipolar. I don't handle bipolar in a relationship because it's weird to me to see a woman stab herself with a knife into her wrist. It freaks me out. Like, what the fuck? I have never seen that before because I've never seen a kid. Most of these kids look up to me when I was doing my stuff in Bed-Stuy, New York. Like, those kids, the two kids were looking up to me as how to help them. In a relationship, if I said that, listen, I'm having problems with what you're doing. Oh, you want to leave me? You want to leave me? And they start taking a knife and stabbing themselves in the wrist. It freaks me out. Like, I don't know what to do. I don't know how to walk on eggshells. This is weird. I travel a long way. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. I'm out of my league because I've never had that happen to me before. Oh my God. Believe me. When I first saw that, that freaked me the fuck out. Like, it wasn't the worst thing in the world. Like, it was, I actually can't even remember what it was because I was so freaked out. Like, hey, listen, I don't like what you're doing. You need to stop with the pills or whatever it was. You know, but you need to calm down. You know, otherwise, you know what? If you can't calm down, you know, maybe I need to find a different place. Oh, you want to leave me now? You want to leave me now? Start and took a knife of the draw. Start stabbing herself in the wrist. And it freaked me the fuck out. Like, oh my fucking God, what the fuck's going on here? This is crazy. I have never been in that situation. You know, I've done, you know, war stuff. I've seen people get shot and killed in front of me. Unfortunately, I had to shoot and kill in front of me, you know, as a soldier. I have never seen a grown woman, beautiful as she is, she was, take a knife, and happened to be a butter knife, stare at me, slam her fucking the knife into her wrist with her all her might, over and over and over and over again, and my eyes lit up. That's like it's never happened to me before. I've dealt with bipolar kids. And they, you know, they look up to me because I, you know, I was an adult. They were kids, and I would help those guys. I don't want to tell his name, but I help him out. I help her out. I help our sister out. I've never been in that situation. It blew my mind, and I knew then, like, oh my God, I'm on an island right now. I don't know what to do right now. Oh my God. Still thinking about it, it still fucks my mind up. Oh man. Jesus Christ, man. I am so worried about this young lady. I'm so worried about her being, she doesn't even understand that she got played out. She doesn't understand that someone took taking advantage of her, but she thinks that she's on top of her game. And I'm not even going to blame him so much. Oh, no, he's a piece of shit. But I'm not going to blame him so much. But no, he's totally a piece of shit. You don't do cowardly shit like that. That's what cowards do. I expect that from, like, Lamar. But a coward. You don't do cowardly shit. You don't be a coward. You want to face me up. But don't be a coward. So that's why most people don't have. That's why now I'm starting to understand why people call people certain names. I'm not gonna call people. I'm not gonna call people anti-black names. I'm not gonna do that because that's what white people do all the time. They've done that throughout generations. But to be a coward like that, a coward, to take advantage of a woman who's so fucked up, and maybe he didn't know she was fucked up the first time. He definitely knew she was fucked up the second time. That's why I have no respect for certain people. I got so much respect for. It seems like, it's funny. It's really funny. The people that really stand out that I know I can call right now and it would pick up my phone call from YouTube. Even though I never met them physically, I know like 7 of them. I know like 10 of them. I can reach out to them and tell them personal details and never, because I already told a bunch of, like, I told like 5 or 6 or 7 of them. I have like probably like 5 or 6 more. I can tell them personal details of my life, the truth, absolute truth. Absolute truth I tell you guys. But I can tell them everything and they would never expose me. Never expose me. And by the way, my exposure is, I tell you already, but I got to tell them the minute details. They would never hurt me. But cowards, insecure jackasses, who will not make any money from this. You know what? You're going to make $1,200 in 3 months? No, $1,200. Why am I talking about $1,200? $1,200, that's what I meant to say. You might make $1,200 in a month talking this shit, you lose credibility, and then in a year you'd be off the air, or you'd be talking the same nonsense, but no one's gonna donate to you. It's funny, I made $1,600 in 3 weeks. Just to get out of Australia from people like you. Thank you, PBS. Because at least I have credibility. At least I tell you the truth. I won't lie to you. I actually forgot what the topic of the story was. And this is the whole thing was. You know what? I'm going to get back on track. I'm going to take a little commercial break so I can get back on track. So. Sassy Cat, thank you for being here. I'm going to take a little commercial break, and I'm going to get back on track here because I'm actually doing more of the RPJ show than I thought I was going to be doing. I thought maybe my guest would show up by now, but she or he has not, and I have no problems with he or she not stopping by, and I got to tell you, I'm actually in love with one of my friends right now. I love one of my friends right now. I actually love a lot of my friends right now. It's funny, a good guy like Ashamed to Be Black. I haven't talked to him in a bit. Great guy. He's if I reach out to him right now. Probably in 2 weeks from now, but he would reach out back to me and say, hey, what's up, man? You what's going on? You need help? You all right? I bet you he's that type of guy. And I'm proud of that. I know what kind of guy he is. And I go, hey, I saw him in your yard. Listen, I ran into some situations right now. Can you help me out? No, it's not money. I just need you to spread the word of my show. He would do it in a heartbeat. 3 weeks later, of course, because you get so much email. And I wouldn't, actually, I wouldn't go on that relationship. I wouldn't do that to that type of, you know. I mean, I got friends that don't even do this stuff that have money, that has situations. It's amazing when you do good things by good people, because you do this over your lifetime. You know, not because you're having to be on YouTube air, like that's the end all be all. But by the way, which will be the end all be all. I mean, internet will be the end all be all. But I mean, I'm a nobody, and people put that, you know, put money into me because they believe in me and they like me and they think that I say the truth, and voila, 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 voila. Yeah, I speak the truth. I don't care, because I think you can learn something from me. You can learn from my mistakes. You can learn from my my arrogance of I can have so many women in the world that I left a good relationship because so many women in the world want me. I made a mistake. That was like 30 years ago, I think, 20 years plus ago. Anyway, folks, I'm gonna take a commercial break. I gotta actually, I didn't plan for this commercial break actually, so I gotta find a song that best hit this spot. You know what? I'm gonna play a song that I like. All right, folks, 1 second. I'm going to take a quick commercial break. And I'll be right back after these commercial words. Why don't hear anything?
Ooh. Thank you. All right, one second. Okay, my good microphone.
All right, folks, listen, you'll never see me as an old fat man. I mean, I'm old right now. I'm doing pretty decent. I have a gorgeous young girlfriend. I don't have much money right now. By March, I'm going to have a few bucks by March. And then whatever I can add to that, I'm going to have a few bucks. And then I had this little car accident thing where I had my, my liver punctured a little bit. I said lacerated. It's more of a puncture. And I'm going to have a few more bucks in a year or two after that. You know, I'm going to have some lost money, too. More than likely. And I'm not going to settle for... Anyway, I'm going to tell you my money, but... that's not really important. What's important here, folks, is topic. The topic is, I don't want Black America to fall down the, and it's already been falling, it's falling down the wayside of, because our reality Black stars, they seem as Black women, Cardi B's, not shine. You got Snoop of Hip Hop New York. I mean, that seemed to be the standard of Black men, because Black men act like these Black lesbian women or these sculpted Botox implanted women. That seems to be the standard. I'm going to be doing this show on both the RPJ show, and maybe I confuse my audience because I don't have a big audience here at all here on the what's this, Johnathan Steele Show? That's all right. That's fine. That's cool and dang. That's cool and gang. I'm going to do this the right way on Johnathan Steele. The RBJ Show, I might do a little bit more raunchy and off the top of my head because I wrote down like so many notes here and I said so many things already that, you know what, the audience didn't come. So to speak. No, I'm just being dick now. But the audience will come. They'll come back as long as I can be consistent. And I'm going to be consistent. My health is steadily improving. I didn't get fat. I didn't get uglier. I'm ugly, you know, because, you know, as you get older, you get ugly, I guess. Or non-attractive. I'm making fun of my own self. I was thinking stuff in my own head about myself. Oh my God. Fucking. I was watching a football play and she got smashed on her face. Oh my God. You all right? Now, she wasn't that good looking anyway, so fuck her. No, I'm kidding. No, but I just find it odd and terrible that Black America falls. And I haven't gotten to the hip-hop music part of this. And, you know, I'm going to be doing shows after this. I'm going to probably do the same show I did today on both RPJ show, which will be a little more ratchet maybe, and then Johnathan Steele, which will be more... you know, precise in its numbers and what's going on. So, I'm happy to be back as Johnathan Steele. I didn't lose my cool. I didn't say anything off the rack or whatever the fucking phrase is. I said everything that was purposeful and meaningful. And I'm proud of everything I've done. My work speaks for itself. All I have to do is look into my archives. Some of the things I'm not proud of in its entirety, I didn't mean to fall down a disastrous road dealing with the you know, divine retardations and pussified men. But I'm trying to do the right thing, and you will see things develop as I go along, because I've got some people in place. I want to put more people in place. I'll be making more videos as I get more people in place. More people want to put money into me. That's great. People want to leave me. That's fine and dandy. I can't do anything about that. Maybe it's a lot of it's my fuck up as well, because, you know, sometimes I get exacerbated. I get annoyed. If you're doing me a favor, then do me a favor, but don't fucking do me a favor half-ass. Do me a favor, don't do me half-ass. Don't act like you do me the world's greatest fucking favor and then I can't do something, because I'm not brilliant. I don't spend 25 hours a day here. I have a life, I have girlfriends here, girlfriends there. I don't have multiple girlfriends. I'm saying that I have situations with situations, you know? I have a life. I'm not 12 years old, I'm not 18 years old, 21 years old, where I have all the free time in the world where I can just spend all my time online. I have no idea what's going on online other than dear friends telling me stuff and producers telling me stuff, which now I know maybe more dear friends than I give them credit for. And I actually might reach out to some of my dear producers who have done me more, have done more for me. I have people who have done more for me, who a lot of people may not think that all my friends have done more for me than anyone else in the world. I have talked to people who have done more for me, and I will, you know, I will never, you know, reveal my people. Unless it's K. Tyler, I would say has done more for me as a friend than anyone I know. For the longest, I have dear friends that I have never met have done more for me than any people that I have met in real life than anyone else in the world have done for me. I am so grateful for the people who have been in my life. They honor me so much. I will do shows after shows after shows on my own dime when I have no money, when I had to scrape for money, I had to beg family and friends for money to keep my show up and running because of them. And I have such a deep gratefulness for them. Even though they might not be here for this show, because my show has not lit up. This is the Johnathan Steele Show. It's not the RPJ Show. The RPJ Show is actually doing better than Johnathan Steele Show right now. Johnathan Steele Show was blowing the doors off a lot of shows that was out there. Here I am struggling with 4 to 6 viewers, 8 viewers, 12 viewers. And I'm proud of the Johnathan Steele Show, because I'm talking real shit, real facts, with real ideas, with real topics. I'm not talking about, hey, he sucks this, and he is a homo, and he is an ugly bastard, and he... Nah, I'm not doing that, not here. I even on an RPJ show, I don't do that shit. Oh, you want to discredit me? You want to hurt my feelings? Well, you can't, because you're nobody. I mean, you can't hurt my feelings, because I know who I really am. I know who I am. I know in life I live, I've had some great loves, situations, monies. I've had it all. I lost it all. I gained it all. I gained it all back. I lost it all. Whatever. That's life. I keep myself in good shape. I will never be a fat bastard. Never. I always will keep myself in good shape. Always. Voila. Ninety-eight years old. I'm always gonna keep myself in good shape. Because I believe that if you keep yourself in good shape, good health, you know, the accident that happened to me, you hurt my, you know, puncture me a little bit, stitches and all, this, that, and the other. Because I'm in good shape, it's probably why I survived it. I am proud of me. I'm proud of, and this is since I was like 15 years old, I put the work into me psychologically, mentally, physically because of organized sports. And I kept that all the way through. I will never be a fat bastard. I'm proud of me. I'm a good guy. I will tell you straight up, you know, I'm a tough guy. I really am. I know I sound like I'm some kind of intellectual. I'm so cool and classic. I'm pretty tough. And I'm vengeful as well. You know, I'll hurt you. Put your hands on me, I'll hurt you. I have boxing abilities and taekwondo abilities. You put your hands on me, I'll put my hands on you. And if I want you, I'll come and get you. But this is not me being trying to be a tough guy. I'm not trying to be a tough, I'm not a tough guy at all. Oh, absolutely not. Oh, no. I'm the toughest guy I've ever known. But I'm not being a tough guy. I'm not gonna beat you up because you said something about me or you said this, that about me. No, I'm not a tough guy like that. Words mean nothing to me. I don't care if you're family. Because I've had my own family because they got disappointed in me because I left America. I left America. And they wanted me here forever. And they said some terrible things about me. You know, daughters, sons, ex-girlfriends, psychopath ex-girlfriends, bipolar ex-girlfriends. They have said some terrible things about me for years. If I don't like how things are rocking and rolling, I dial out and then I'm seeking a plan out. I'm not mad at you. I understand why you get angry at me when I leave. I understand why you get upset with me when I dial out. Like, hey, listen, I'm already making plans to go back to America. I'm making plans to go to Argentina or Cyprus or Italy. No, not Italy. Sorry, Germany. I'm already making plans to go to Germany. Now my new plans are, well, I'm going to go either back to Australia or Russia, and if I have a dame in mind, long-term plans, I'm gonna make plans long-term in my mind to be with her, whether it's North Carolina or whatever the place may be. I'm not gonna even say what the next place I could be at. I'm gonna make plans long-term. I know this is a little more personal than I probably wanted to get into, but I'm gonna make plans. I'm not afraid to live my life. I'm not afraid to explore. I'm not afraid to try. I put everything on the line because I believe in me. I always bet on me. And I bet on the next woman that I think that can deal with someone as strong as I am, because I believe that they need to be strong as I am. Because I don't want confrontation. I want someone to help me as I help them, you know? We build on top of each other. We push each other. That's how I didn't even talk about this. This wasn't even part of my my platform for the night. I want to build, and I think that most people should want to do this. Like, hey, find a man or woman that you can build on top, that pushes each other one way or the other. Not always so much confrontational, but in lovingly, sometimes lovingly, like, hey, let's push each other so we can build upon each other. So I help you get to this plateau. You help me get to this plateau. You know, you want to go to medical school? Here, I put 8 years of me doing two jobs, a full-time job and a weekend job, every other weekend job, to help you go to vocational school to, you know, learn plumbing or something, because you're into plumbing. You've been into plumbing for the longest, or whatever the case may be. Or hey, help. Let's say in my situation, all I need is equipment for personal training, because I love working out myself. So working out is easy for me. So maybe wherever I go, help me get some weights. Help me put the flyers out. And you put $12,000 into me 1 year. Let's just say $12,000. That's actually a lot of money. But let's say $12,000 or $10,000. To put flyers out, buy equipment, buy workout, buy the weights, buy the cones, help me get in my best shape so I can show the clients workout gear. And then I can rock and roll with that. And I did that on my own like 25 years ago. I did it on my own. So I had a partner to help, believe in me to do those things. Ah, that's excellent. That would be excellent. Let's say my partner was a nurse. So what can I do for you to help you build? So how about this? Every dollar I make from personal training, I'm going to help you become a physician assistant. Physician assistant. Am I saying the right thing? Yeah. Or you want to be a doctor? Every dollar I got goes into you to be a doctor. If you're a nurse, I want you to go to the next plateau. Don't rest. Yes, you can sit there and put your time in. You can be the top of the nurse team. I want you to be better than that. I want you to be a physician assistant. I think that's the next plateau. And how about this on your own, a physical therapist on your own? Let's get your certification. Let's get your equipment you need so you can run your own physical therapy in your own garage. Let's fix the garage up so you can be. That's what I want. That's what I want. I want a partnership. Me. That's what I want you guys to want, partnerships with real women and men. You first must marry. You must commit to each other first. Commit to each other first. Commit. You can't just say willy-nilly, I love you, you love me, we hump a lot. No, commit. I like you. We hump a little bit. I like you. I love you. Marry. No, then we start putting money into it. Let's make it legal. That should be the standard. Marry, commit to one another, build upon that. We forgot about that. All of the world has forgotten about that. Commit to one another, put money into each other. Idealize what we're gonna do with each other. I mean, it's really not that hard for me. I see it so simple. I don't understand how people have forgotten about this. And I'm not an old fuddy-duddy. I understand, one-night stands and all these things. One-night stands, you just got to, hey, listen, I just don't want to have a kid out in the world that doesn't have a father. So I rub her up. And if I can't control myself, like some kind of baby. Am I a baby? I'm not a baby, so I don't need to have sex so badly where it just I lose my mind. Commit to one another. If you really enter each other, marry each other. Commit to each other so much so that you put everything into each other. women can't be so insecure. And I believe in, you know, I would believe in, I do believe in equality. Women and men are equal in all ways. Proven. No woman can lift weights as much as I lift weights. If I lift 300 pounds and a woman lifts 120 pounds, which is, you know, she shouldn't earn the same as I earn. That makes sense, right? I mean, it's only make, like, if I lift 300 pounds and she lifts 120 pounds, there's no way she should make the same as I make, right? Oh, she tried as hard as she could. Well, that's not, it's a performance. It's performance based. Let's not kid ourselves. Let's not be a baby about it. Let's not be a little kid about it. It's performance based. 300 pounds and 120 pounds is a huge difference, and it should be a huge difference in money. But if we lift 120 each, then we get paid each. And believe me, I have a lot of granddaughters, and I believe if they can do the same that I can do, they should get paid the same as I can do. And I'm all over the place, right? I'm talking about everything. All right, anyway. All right, folks, listen. It's a little late now, and I've talked a lot of nonsense. I'll be back on tomorrow. I've been consistent for 2 days. I just haven't been consistent on the same show, but I'll be on tomorrow. And I'm in a good mood. And I believe in everything I said. Hopefully you guys are following me along. My name is Johnathan Steele. This has been the Johnathan Steele Show. Thank you very much for sticking around and listening to a jackass like me. Because you're a jackass just like me. Later.